This tiny teach is about the lactose or lac operon. The lac operon is an example of an inducible operon. That means that the structural genes are usually in the off position, but they can be turned on if needed. Before we talk about the lac operon, let's review what an operon is. An operon is just a segment of DNA that has a regulatory gene that controls transcription and translation of some structural genes. So in the lac operon, the regulatory gene is I, and the regulatory gene is transcribed and translated all the time, and we are constantly producing a repressor protein. The regulatory gene I controls transcription and translation of three structural genes in the lac operon, lac Z, lac Y, and lac A. If these structural genes are transcribed and translated, the bacteria produce enzymes they need to break apart the sugar lactose. So first we're going to talk about the lac operon when there's no lactose present in the environment. If there's no lactose present in the environment, the bacteria doesn't need to produce enzymes to break apart the sugar lactose. Why would we make enzymes to break something apart that we don't even have available? So the lac operon, when no lactose is present, the structural genes are in the off position, meaning they're not being transcribed or translated. How this happens is, again, we're constantly transcribing and translating the regulatory gene to produce the repressor protein. The repressor protein binds to a part of the operon called the operator. This is just a little section of the actual operon. And when the repressor protein binds to the operator, it stops transcription and translation of these three structural genes. So RNA polymerase wants to come in and transcribe and translate these structural genes, but actually the repressor protein binding to the operator stops that from happening. This makes sense. There's no lactose present in the environment, so I don't need to transcribe and translate these three structural genes that produce enzymes that are needed to break apart the sugar lactose. Now let's talk about what happens for the lac operon when lactose is present in the environment. Again, the lac operon is an example of an inducible operon. So now lactose is present in the environment, we want to turn the structural genes on, meaning we want to transcribe and translate them so we can produce enzymes to break apart the sugar lactose. Since lactose is present in the environment, the bacteria need the enzymes to break apart that sugar. The setup is the same. We have the regulatory gene I, it's being transcribed and translated all the time, and it's producing a repressor protein. And we have the three structural genes, lac Z, lac Y, and lac A, that if we transcribe and translate, we produce enzymes we need to break apart the sugar lactose. The difference here is because lactose is present in the environment, although the repressor protein is being made, because we are transcribing and translating the regulatory gene, it's lactose that actually binds to the repressor protein and prevents it from binding to the operator. So we're making the repressor, but the repressor is inactive. It can't bind to the operator. So here comes RNA polymerase. It's going to transcribe, and eventually these three structural genes are going to be translated, and we're going to produce the enzymes that we need to break apart the sugar lactose.